This is the day when South Africa decides on the future of our country, who should lead the government of South Africa. And I have no doubt whatsoever in my heart of hearts that the people will once again invest confidence in the African National Congress to continue to lead this country. I went into the voting station and greeted the various party agents and urged them to be relaxed and to smile. And then I proceeded to cast my vote. So it's a wonderful day, and I think it will go very well throughout the country. The chair of the commission tells me that we've got 190 observers who've come to observe our election. And I'm sure, as always, the IEC will run a good election, and they will once again deliver a really good results outcome. I've been very impressed, even as I've watched their operations from afar. I haven't visited the center yet. It's one of the best, world-class, well-organized, well-executed. So I think the IEC gets my vote today. It's a pity they didn't run as a party, but they get my vote. So thank you very much for all of you being here.
Sesike sabona ke futhi la esikoleni hitekani khona la eShawelo eSoweto sekufika ke uMongameli wezo uMnumzane Cyril Matamela Ramaphosa lapho ke bezofaka khona ivoti lakhe khona njengamanje emva kwemizuzwana nje engengakanani eyedlule. Kwenye ke inkulumo kaRamaphosa uye wabalula ukuthi ulethemba kakhulu ke iqembu aloholayo okuyi African National Congress ukuthi ke lizokwenza kahle kakhulu ukhethweni njengoba enethemba ngomkhankaso wabo noma ngathi ke nomgqiqo womkhankaso wabo abathe bawenza ngaphambi ke kokhetho. Njengenhloli yona ke enkenteza njengengede igijima ayihambisa umbiko ekumkhulu. Nathi ke selokhu sikubikele njalo ngakho konke okwenzekayo njengoba besike sabika phambilini mbukeli ukuthi ngabe yikuphi okuqhubekayo njengoba kuqhubeka usuku lokhetho eNingizimu Afrika yonkana. Kanti ke thina sigxile kakhulu la esifundazweni saseGoli lapho ke sibuka khona imiphakathi eyehlukene ukuthi ngabe ivota nje kungakanani ukukhala ebhekene nakho eindaweni engamalukishi afana nenomzamo okujwayelekile ukuhlupha iy'nkinga ey'fana namanzi nogesi kanye nabo ubugebengu njengoba usubalile. Ngifisa ukubheka nje ukuthi la sinjani isimo senu sika gesi kanjalo namanzi ungabe kulethwa ngendlela efanele
lutho akulethi ngendlela efanele ngekhansela lana masiyo ireportela ayinandaba nathi kuthi inomzamo ngoba yilokishi encane entsha abanankinga nathi namaphoyisa akanandaba nathi akangeni athi akangeni ebusuku manje besicela nje ukuthi ulento igovernment azame ukuthi asize kule ndaba yokuthi yonke into ibe right la enomzamo siyacela. Nobugebengu asekho safe la abantwana bethu bayadutshulwa nabobhuti bethu bayadutshulwa nokuhlala endlini asiphephile bayangena ngama-window iy'gebengu zifike zisirape endlini zifike zisidubule zisibula zithathe imali yethu esinayo incane.
Ngokubuka kwakho kwedadewethu kusukela namuhla nje ngoba nivota nje ikuphi nje obona ukuthi kungeza noshintsho noma ikuphi ofisa ukuthi ukubone kushintsha kulo mphakathi enwakhele phezu kwazo zonke le y'nkinga osuyibalulile.
Into engifuna ukuthi ichintshe ukuthi ngifuna ukuthi amaphoyisa angene nomzamo ukuthi ugesi abe khona ukuthi amanzi abe khona ukuthi nomgaqo abe khona.
Umuntu ongazama ukungena kwakhe la ongasisiza intuthuko imisebenzi ulutsha alusebenzi abantu badinga impilo engcono nakuqala. Sikulungiswa izitrato indaba yegesi apha enomzamo indaba abantwana abancane abanandawo ezokudlala kahle and ne crime iningi la enomzamo igcwele nje kakhulu i crime ngasike ugovernment lo zongena zonke izibhamu ezibulala abantu la eSouth Africa ziphume ziphele zithathwe izibhamu une license awuna license kodwa isibhamu si inkinga uthando ebantwini alusekho
njengoba niphumile nje nizovota iliphi ithemba enalo namhlanje ikuphe nibona ukuthi kungaguquka ingabe nesenalo yini ithemba lokuthi ningasengalibona ushintsho kulezi gemegeme ezingaka ezenziwa uhulumeni waseNingizimu Afrika
Sanibona mntaba ngokama womhlangabezi ngakwangcukana. Ntaba into engizoyikhuluma mina njengamanje ne. Mhlawumbe uma ngathiwa kushintshwa uhulumeni ophethe njengamanje kuphatha ubunye mhlawumbe usizo singalithola noma singalithola kodwa bengifisa ukuthi kushintshwe nje uhulumeni kimi. Aqhele lophethe njengamanje.
Mhlawumbe ungena kahulumeni omusha ubona ukuthi kuphi angafika nakho okungaxazulula lezi nkinga eninazo.
Kushintsha kwahulumeni mntaba mhlawumbe lona ozobe ekhona manje mhlawumbe uyoza ngamandla. Asize kulezinto eziningi esikhala ngazo ukuthi iziningi into ezenzakala endaweni lasihleli nakwezinye indawo especially nje ukushona nje kwabantu singazuthi babulawelane
kunesimo esibonakalayo uma uzungeza ilokishi lase lomzamo sezindlu kubukeka sengathi azandile kangaka izindlu zoxhaso mhlawumbe ukuphawula kwakho njengesakhamuza kule ndawo ungabe unalo ulwazi olukhona lokuthi kungani na isimo sakule ndawo kubukeka ngathi nje izindlu zoxhaso azikho njengakwezinye indawo engamalokishi afuzela
Ngokucabanga kwami mdaba bangendlela engibona ngayo ababezakhe sithi mhlawumbe ngicabanga ukuthi labahlulwa isikhala sokuzakha indawo lehlala kuyona incane vele
Ntaba bokugcina nje ithemba lakho lithini ngokhetha esibheke kulona noma esikulo njengamanje njengoba kunamhlanje
Ngithi kubantu laba ehleli khona ngifuna bavotele inhlangano ekuyona ekuzobe lenza izinto ezilungile engake ngisho ukuthi yiphi igama layo
Ntaba baba sibonge kakhulu ngesikhathi sakho Lokho bekungomunye futhi wezakhamuzi osetheke naye wabeka uvulo wakhe ngoba sazi ke embukela uthi abantu abaye nganxanye bengemanzi ngakho ke siyohlale sithola imbono eyehlukene kubo bonke abantu esithi sikhulume nabo bengengasho ngathi njengenhloli yona enkento eza njengengede ibheke kweyiso omkhulu ihambisa umbiko sizoloku siqhubeka futhi sinilethela njengoba zinjalo siletha konke okwenzekayo kuyo yonke imiphakathi esothi sihambele usuku lwanamhlanje ukubheka nje ukuthi njengoba kuwusuku lokhetho namhlanje njengoba kuwusuku lokuthi abantu bayovota yini le engaka abayebenza ke ukuthi belangazelele ukuphuma beyovota beyidele bedele ukushisa kwelanga bephume beyokhethweni yini le engaka abafisa ukuyibona ishintshe emiphakathini yabo sebephawulileke abantu basenomzamo bakhalaye ngakho konke asebekubalulile okuhlanganisa ingqalasizinda noma ngathi ke nobugebengu nokunye nje kokuningi abakubalile sizoqhubeka ke futhi siye nakwezinye izindawo ukuyobheka nje ukuthi bakhala ngani abantu futhi banaliphi ithemba ngalolu khetho
As you can see, we are standing right in front of the voting station in the area. People are still queuing up to vote. And if you look across, you will see two banners from the ANC and the IFP, clearly indicating that this area is a two-horse race between the two parties because there's not so much dominance from other political parties as you would expect. And just before we dwell on to the events of today and what this day means for the dwellers of this hostel. I'm just going to bring in a community leader of the hostel, Utatu Tumisane Ncube, to talk us through today's day. Babu Ncube, siyabulela ngesikhathi sakho baba.
Sibonga kakhulu nani.
Babu Ncube, namhlanje siyabona nabo abantu bagcwele ukuzovotwa. Lithini lo langa for abantu abahlala kule hostel yase Deep Roof?
Mina ke igama lami nguTumisane Ncube, osobaba waleli khaya. Hey, engakusho sisijabule kakhulu ngendlela esimanga kuba sizothola lolu khetho lufana na noluka 1994 kubantu ngendlela abajabule ngakhona ngaphakathi kwe-Deep Roof nokubambisana nanokubekezelelana kusho nje okukhulu ngaphakathi kwe-Deep Roof hostel lokhu
yini baba enifuna lolu khetho lunenzele lona oluphi ushintsho mhlawumbe ubangayibeka ngaleyo ndlela ukuthi oluphi ushintsho enifuna ukulibona kuleli khetho
kulolu khetho ushintsho singafisa ukulibona ukuthi ngathi kungamuva enye iparty kungene enye iparty sibone ukuthi singaya kanjani kuyaphambili ngoba kuningi okonakele ilusha alusebenzi abantu abahlezi labahlezi nje indlala iyababulala sifisa ngathi kungaba noshintsho olukhulu nje olungenzeka ngaphakathi kwale hostela noma ezweni nje lonke esibaholayo abantu ukuze bekwazi ukuthi ulusha likwazi ukuthola imisebenzi
Le hostela baba yase Deep Roof yi hostela efana namanye ama hostela ala eGauteng. A few months ago mangicabanga beku March mhla nivale imigaqo ni protesta nifuna uhulumeni waseGauteng aze kunina ningabantu ngoba ninezikhalo ezithile. Igcine ihambe kanjani indaba yezikhalo?
Awu sibonga kakhulu kuhulumeni wakwazi ukusizwa kakhulu ukukhala kwethu ukuphuma komphakathi ukwazi kuyilwela wakwazi ukuza uhulumeni weza kuthina sisebenza naye kahle kakhulu nezindlu seyilungisiwe namanzi asekhona kulungiswa ama toilet kwathi azoqala mhla ka 1 kuJune ngoba kuzoba uyizi 1 nje konke ukusebenza kwethu kunokubambisana ne movement kuyaphambili inhle kakhulu phakathi kwethu nohulumeni sibonga kakhulu nje Nagini futhi intatheli siyabonga ukuthi nikwazi ukuthi nize nisikhiphele emhlabeni ukuthi kwenzakalani ngaphakathi ukukhona okwenzakala izindlu iphelile lebesikala ngaso ugesi usukhona amanzi asekhona ama toilet ayaqala ngey1 la flush ayabesikade sikala ngawo
so akusekho nisakhala ngawo manje
okwamanje hayi kusase kahle yonke into ngoba nale hostel ebiwa besikala ngayo bathi iyaqala nje ukuthi ilungise ngoba abantu bezongena ezindlini ukuzodilizwa yona njengamanje iyaqala nje maybe kuleli viki ezayo
Thank you, Siyabonga Baba. Right, that was one of the community leaders in this area, Ubaba Dumisane Ncube, basically talking about the state of the hostel. Last month, in March, the community of this area took to the streets to barricade roads, basically protesting about the state of the hostel. And as we've heard it from Ubaba Dumisane Ncube, they saying that government heeded their calls. The hostels are being fixed. Toilets are also going to be installed. So there's not much that they are really complaining about at the moment. Also talking about the voter turnout today, basically saying that voters in this area are excited about today. They're excited about this opportunity. It is the seventh democratic election. Of course, one of the biggest elections since the dawn of democracy. But I'm just going to ask my camera person, Debuko, to just pan for you so you see the state of this hostel before the buildings were fixed. You can see across the road that there's been broken windows, the roofs have been falling, and a lot of people were complaining about unemployment, drugs, crime also currently taking place in this area. But Babu Ncube has come out to say now that the government is addressing such issues and also highlighting the fact that like any other people, like any other community, they too are also looking for change, and they believe that the incoming government will be the change that the hostel dwellers in this place need. Just a brief history of this hostel. It was established in 1970. It housed miners who were working in mines around Gauteng. Now the influx of people coming to this hostel has increased. Basically, they are overcrowded. Basically, the unfavorable living conditions. A lot of issues were raised in terms of this hostel. It's not the only hostel in Gauteng. There's a couple of hostels in Gauteng that hostel dwellers have the same grievances or had the same grievances as these dwellers had in the past. But as Babu Ncube said, the government has heeded their call, and all they look forward to now is a change of leadership.
This is one of those areas where there has been great concerns when it comes to crime, criminality, and citizens in this area feel like their safety has been threatened over and over again.
We're all hoping for something to change in our community, especially with the gangsterism and everything that's been happening. I feel like as we can, if we all come together as one, we'll be able to, you know, we'll be able to help stop crime and everything else that's not supposed to be there. So my hopes for voting is that can we as South Africa, you know, as a community, come together as one and make it better for our people.
Well, if truth be told, since my very first vote, and up till now, to me, this is my personal view, things has gone worse, especially here in Westbury, with all the killings, with all the corruption, with all the drug selling, people dying senselessly. So things has gone very bad as opposed to the first time that we voted. So there was no change at all. My hope is really for change, because like I said before, things are bad. If you have looked around Westbury, we're in a bad condition. Westbury is actually dying.
My vote is the change for the community is to for our youngsters to get work, and we want our elders to be treated better, and we need better services in the community. Yeah, for the youngest generation, for our Westbury, it's for the children to prosper in school. The changes in school needs to become, and for our children to get into colleges, and those who want to go and work, they need to go and work. There must be job opportunities, because for them to finish school and just to sit on corners and stand on streets, and that's where crime started. And we need a change in our police force as well. We need a change also.
As we continue this very important journey on Election Day, we're now in Bryanston at one of the voting polls. And one of the main topics that most South Africans have on their mind is the high unemployment rate when it comes to youth unemployment, and also how should we foster and boost entrepreneurship in the country to ensure a better future for South Africa. I'm now joined by one of the residents in Bryanston who's come to make a difference and to come and vote this morning. His name is Jeff Weinstein. Mr. Jeff, thank you so much for taking the time to speak to us.
Pleasure, Morwick.
Jeff, I mean, we are at 32.9% unemployment rate. Everyone is looking at a new government. What is your expectations with the new, and it's the seventh administration that's coming in. This has been 30 years since the ANC has been in power. What is your expectations for this new government?
Well, I would hope that this new government would obviously pay serious attention to attending to the unemployment problem in the country. My personal view is we need to fix our education. Education seems to be in a state of disrepair. I think that we need, personally, I would want a government that came into being that was user-friendly in terms of creating investment and attracting foreign investment into the country to boost our job potential. South Africa's got the most amazing infrastructure, our freeways, our factories, everywhere you go. We have the capacity to have a booming economy, but we are being seriously mismanaged at this moment in time. So we need an administration that comes to the fore that is pro-capitalist leanings. Obviously, we need some social mix in the country. Most successful economies today have a mix of capitalism and socialism, but we need to fix our education, and we need to boost our skills development, and we need to create an environment that is user-friendly for people, business people, to feel confident in the country, to invest, and thereby create jobs. So that's what I'm hoping for.
There's a possibility that, you know, the ANC might not get the 50%. And as you have alluded to, you know, we are looking at attracting an environment or a new political environment that is business friendly for foreign investors to come in and also local investors. In terms of coalition, you know, your expectations, do you think that, you know, where we are right now, stats, stuff that's been around, you know, that we are looking at a new government that's going to be a coalition government, or is it still going to be one party that continues to govern the country?
It seems to me from my readings that the ANC is going to attract about 43% of the vote. That's based on various polls I've looked at. The EFF is obviously going to be a kingmaker potentially at around 10 or 12%. We've got the new MK party at around 10 or 12%. And then we have the DA at around 20 or 22%. So does the ANC go into a coalition with the DA, which I think personally would probably be good for the country, or does it go into a coalition with the EFF, which personally I think would be bad for the country? But I'm not a fortune teller, and politics makes strange bedfellows. You could find that the ANC is sidelined completely and all the other parties get together and create a new governing party and sideline the ANC as the opposition.
As the day continues, yes, it is a lovely day and the lines are quite long, and we're coming live from Bryanston. And we really want to understand, you know, people are really eager, and this is a day that people have been anticipating for a very long time. This is a really important time for South Africa and for many South Africans. I'm joined by one of the voters that has come to make her mark in Bryanston at one of the voting polls. Her name is Fazeka. Fazeka, thank you so much for taking the time to speak to us.
Thank you, guys.
Fazeka, just wanted to know from you, you know, the party that you are going to be voting for. We are faced with such a high unemployment rate. There's not a lot of jobs. So what is your expectations for the new governing party that's coming in?
I'm hoping that the new governing party is going to be able to help create jobs for the youth, and not only create jobs, but also help with mindset development in the youth. Because that's where the foundation is. If the youth do not have the right mindset, they can't start businesses, they can't get into jobs, they don't have the right direction. So we really need to start at the foundation with children in primary schools, in high schools, and just give them the right mindset as to how to build their careers and so on.
As we continue in Bryanston, it is getting quite full. People are lined up. South Africans are really showing up. They are determined to see a difference. And we do hope that everyone is going to make the correct decisions today. But I am joined by a very special voter, and she's actually from the Western Cape. But this year she decided to come and make her mark in the northern suburbs of Johannesburg. I'm now joined by Andre. Andre, thank you so much.
Thank you. Hello.
Andre, today is a very imperative day in our country. It's the 29th, and we are putting our votes. It's the seventh administration that's coming in. What are your expectations in terms of the political party that you're going to be making your mark, or your hopes for the new governing party?
So as we were practicing earlier, and I didn't realize we weren't live yet, I was reading a stat this morning on Al Jazeera that said that not only has youth unemployment increased, but educated youths are unemployed. And so I think the only thing I can hope for when I go in here to make my mark is that we find a government that fosters jobs for educated young people, continue to find opportunities for educated young people, but also try and find opportunities for young people that don't necessarily have to go down the tertiary route. There are different ways to create jobs, entrepreneurship, like you said, apprenticeships. That's all phenomenal if we can find the space to get these people jobs. And that's why I'll be putting up my mark today, is as a young person myself who is recently in the job world and job market, that's what I'd hope for.
Gershel, there you have it as we wrap up from Bryn Irvin Primary School in Bryanston. You know, voters are really excited to see a difference, and all voters and everyone that we have spoken here today are all in agreement that we need a new governing party that is going to implement strategies to curb the high unemployment rate and also boost young entrepreneurs to foster new jobs for the country.
So I hope it's going to bring change. That's what we need, change and a better life. If you have looked around Westbury, we're in a bad condition.
Ngizizwa ngijabule kakhulu namhlanje thina siyintsha sikhona nathi ukuba nama input wethu elifeini sikhona nokubona impumelelo kulento esizoyivotela namhlanje ndingijabule kakhulu.
Mina ngifuna ukubona nje imali yethu yabo gogo yomholo ithe ukuthi ukukhuphuka. Izinto ziyadura. Ya abantwana bayakhala thina bogogo sithwele ubunzima. Mabanga sikhuphulela nje balo mholo basilungisele neitrada manje sambe inhlabathini.
And I'm sure as always the IEC will run a good election and they will once again deliver a really good results outcome.
Voters in this area are excited about today. They're excited about this opportunity. It is the seventh democratic election, of course, one of the biggest elections since the dawn of a democracy.
Abantu bethembise beloko bethu bazo create imisebenzi eyi 2 million. Asikaze sibone lo msebenzi leyo.